The final in double overtime here in Corvallis. Scoreless between Oregon State and the visiting Missouri Tigers. And along with Kelly, and I'll tell you, Oregon State had its chances.
Well, you know, I think the player of the match may be the post. There was so many shots off the post. Early in the game, this is 2 minutes into the game. Jones just misses a sitter, if you want to call it that. But here's post number one. That ball misjudged by the goalkeeper up over her head off the crossbar. But both goalkeepers were just phenomenal today. And Geist, you're going to see fully outstretched, keeping that one out, keeping the scores at zero. And just the timing, saving that ball that's coming across. You never know really when to dive there. And she times everything perfect. You know, she just was an absolute dominant force for Oregon State today.
So scoreless after the first half. Second half, Missouri looking to get on the board.
And a great chance here. But Geist, again, just focused, closes down that space, keeps her eye on the ball. The miss hit from Missouri, and she's able to just push that ball wide of the post. And the best chance of the second half for Oregon State. Off one post, off two posts, and it falls to Nickerson. Can she put it away? No. We still stay at zeros.
All right, first overtime, and here's where I thought this thing was going to be over.
1 minute in a great run behind the defense, and Oregon State just not able to put it away. Nikki Ferris, such a good run in behind.
So that's where we stand, Kelly. Nil-nil. Anything jump out at you as far as the numbers are concerned?
You know, this was a pretty even game both sides, and I think it's a good early match for both teams to see where they stand and where they can build upon going into the rest of the season.
So Missouri will travel to face a very tough Nebraska club on Sunday. Oregon State will host Kansas on Sunday. Thanks so much for joining us, Ann and Kelly saying so long from Corvallis.